Good afternoon, everybody. This is Dr. Tony Della here with the co-director of the High School Summer Research Academy program. First off, welcome. Thank you for participating this year. This will be a very unique experience as we have never run the HSRA as a remote program. So I think that a lot of people are excited and maybe a little bit nervous about how it's going to go, but I think it will be great. So to start with, I want to just say that the contact information for myself and the co-director, Dr. Mary Ramsey, are included in the orientation material that's included in the email that was just sent out. So first thing I want to talk about is registration. So the registration occurs through a program called Circuitry, which UT has a license with to run summer programs with high school students. It's important that you get this registration finished up and submitted, most importantly because it allows us then to generate what's called an electronic ID or an EID. All students at UTexas, including summer camp students, are issued an EID, and that allows them to access libraries, access databases, be able to sign on to secure programs through the university. Basically, everything operates through a UT EID. So the faster you can get through the registration through Circuitry, the faster we can generate an EID for you, and then we can get you going. So an EID allows you mainly three things. It allows you access to Zoom, Canvas, and Box. So Zoom, I think everyone knows what Zoom is at this point. Our version of Zoom is secured through UT and their services. So it is a highly secure format of Zoom, but it's exactly the same as any other Zoom session you've been in. It's just, it goes through your EID such that it is a secure link. Canvas is a classroom management software program. I don't know if many of you, maybe some high schoolers, have been exposed to Blend. It is effectively the same thing as Blend. It's just rebranded, repackaged for a college campus. And so this is what most of the research faculty will be using to organize the materials that will be used during the research during the 5 weeks. And so again, you need an EID in order to access Canvas through UT's system. And then finally, Box. UT has a license with Box. Again, a very secure way to store and organize files that you're going to be handling with your research materials this summer. Again, you need an EID to be able to sign into that. So it's really important that you get through the registration process so that we can generate an EID for you. And again, the orientation email has detailed instructions about how to use your EID to reset the password set so you can use it. Okay, so your research group. I've had lots of questions regarding various research groups and questions about research and different timings and would this be okay, would that be okay? I'm very sorry if I can't specifically answer those questions, but we have 15 different research groups this summer, and I don't know the specifics of all of my colleagues' research. So those questions need to be answered by the research faculty. And so once you get an EID, your information will be given to that faculty lead so that they can contact you and get you started in terms of setting up an initial meeting time during the first start date, and inform you about the specifics of the research and the logistics of the meeting times. Okay, so in general, the idea that we surround ourselves with is that it is much more enjoyable to learn about science by doing it rather than just reading about it. That is the crux of our program, is students are more motivated by doing research rather than simply reading about it in a textbook or on a Wikipedia page or anywhere else. So you can expect that you're going to be immediately or nearly immediately put in a situation where you're going to be doing something. You're going to be working with a program to generate data. You're going to be going out and collecting data potentially for your research project. So expect that. Our research faculty are experts in their field of research, but they're also experts in understanding student motivation and pedagogy of getting students to learn more effectively through research. So just be expected of that. That may be your experience in your high school courses, maybe it isn't, but that's really one of the main focuses of our program. So you'll have the research faculty there during the Zoom sessions, on a daily basis. They will be accompanied by undergraduate research peer mentors. So these are undergraduate students who work in our research labs. So they have content knowledge and they have research backgrounds and they've done this stuff before in some capacity. And so they're there also to help out with the research projects and guide you through the research process. Another important point is that you do not have to have any prior knowledge of the research topic in the group that you're placed in beforehand. That is not assumed. Everything that you need to know and learn to be able to perform the research will be shown to you during these 5 weeks. And once again, just be prepared that this is an active learning situation. This should not be just lecturing, okay? So you're going to be doing things. Okay, on the communication front, in terms of how will I communicate or how will I learn about stuff, main communication between you and the research faculty can occur, obviously through the Zoom sessions that you have daily. You can also email them questions. Just expect that their responses will typically happen between the hours of 8 and 6, Monday through Friday. This is for legal reasons. Just know that that's probably going to be the case. As far as communication with your peers, so other participants, participants should feel free to, use their favorite chat app, WhatsApp, GroupMe, whatever it is that teenagers use these days. I don't know. I'm old enough now to not really know what these things are, but you should feel free to use those apps to communicate between participants. What we do not allow is for the research faculty or even the undergraduate peer mentors who are in the labs to communicate through these chat services. Again, this is for legal reasons that we are technically dealing with minors and we cannot monitor that chat. So please do not invite research faculty or peer mentors, undergraduate peer mentors, to join in your chats. That's not allowed. As far as Zoom sessions, the Zoom is secure through UT's system. There will be two people who what we call designated individuals. A designated individual is someone who's gone through specific training to work with minors. And so the research faculty and all the undergraduate peer mentors are all designated individuals. So there will always be two of them present at all times in Zoom sessions. The private chat function in Zoom will be turned off, again, for reasons that we can't monitor private chat, so we have to disable it. And finally, all the sessions, the Zoom sessions, will be private and they will be unique numbers generated such that no one else will be able to join into those sessions. So the other thing is just be aware of the appropriate behavior that you should normally see in a Zoom session. Dress appropriately, have appropriate backgrounds behind you. Try to avoid distraction and distracting environments, if at all possible, while you're in Zoom sessions. And finally, if you see something off or strange, let the research faculty know, or let me know. If you see something, say something. We do not expect any strange behavior, but know that we do everything we do our best in order to be trained and cognizant of potential behaviors that may occur. So definitely do not expect any of that, but just know that we do have that in mind. All right, so I think the rest of the information should be included in a couple of PDFs that are attached to the orientation email that was sent out, along with a code of conduct form that I'd like to have you sign, and then you can drop it into this link in order to consider that signed. So the main things is, if you haven't already, a lot of people have, if you haven't already, get into the registration through the circuitry link that was provided in your acceptance, and get that taken care of such that we can get the UTE ID generated and get you going. So if you have further questions, obviously feel free to email us at the HSRA email. The contact information is all in the documentation in that email. Otherwise, I hope to see you all very soon. Take care.